Right.
Good morning. We have just arrived at Battambang. We're just on a tuk-tuk over to the hotel. I'll talk to you when we get there. We're kind of shattered. It's about 6 o'clock in the morning. We've checked into our hotel. I'm knackered after walking up those few flights of stairs. I had a horrendous night's sleep. So we got, last I left yesterday, we were in Phnom Penh. It was like midnight. We had to wait till about 1 o'clock-ish for a bus to arrive, our next bus. When it did arrive, it was not as nice as the other one in terms of like space and stuff. We ended up having to get a bottom bunk. There is like literally no space. Look, it's like right there. We wanted a top one, but there was none left. It's now 1 o'clock in the morning. We're getting to sleep.
Yeah.
So yeah, we were on that bottom bunk. There was no headspace. It was hot, but I mean, it was alright. We just kind of fell straight to sleep. But I kept waking up all through the night. They kept just stopping for toilet breaks. And I don't know. It was just dead noisy. So I.
Would you stop for a
toilet break? When everyone should be asleep, I don't know. I think the driver needed the toilet and so they just stopped, like, not at a proper toilet, just somewhere. Anyway, enough of the moaning. We're finally here. It's about 6:30. Give you a quick room tour. It's quite nice, this hotel. It was quite cheap as well. So, we come in here, through the door, and we've got two beds. We haven't got any. Oh yeah, we have got aircon. Oh no, I think we have to pay extra for aircon. I'm not entirely sure.
Well, it does
say
on here.
Does it? Oh right, okay. I'm not entirely sure. TV, wardrobe, and then bathroom. I've not looked at. Is it in here, Stephen?
Yeah.
Bathroom. Oh, quite a big bathroom. What we need: toilet, sink, shower. The tuk-tuk driver that brought us to the hotel is going to come back to the hotel at 1 o'clock and take us to the bamboo train, which is the main reason why we've come to Battambang. So we've got a couple of hours before then. We might just have a little rest, go and get some breakfast later on and have a little explore before that. We might just sit and wait for him. I'm not entirely sure, but anyway, catch you when I'm a bit more with it. We are heading out now. We're going to go and meet our tuk-tuk driver, who should be here at the hotel and reception. He's going to take us over to the bamboo train and over to the bat caves. We're on our tuk-tuk heading over to the bamboo train. It's the first stop, and I don't really know where we're going. We think it's just bamboo train and then like bat caves, but who knows? We just have trusted our tuk-tuk driver to take us. This is the Battambang Provincial Hall, where we just had a little brief stop off at.
Hello.
Hello.
You go there by the train, you stop there, it's about 10 or 20 minutes. You walk around, you will see some places there. Then you come back here, the same Mumu train.
Okay.
And your driver, he waits you here.
Ah, okay.
Then
okay.
You come back to meet him.
Okay.
Then you pay conductor, 10 or left for bus.
10.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. We've arrived at the bamboo train. Okay, we're off on the bamboo chain. They're off in front of us. Going along, it's only single rail track, so we've met like another one going in the opposite direction, so you have to get it off and dismantle it and put it back. This has been putting it back. Take a picture. Oh. We're the last one. There's about 8 of us that all went off at the same time from that side. It's quite cool that we're the last ones, because then we get to see them like putting them back together. This is mad. Oh, how quiet and nice does that sound now? It goes so fast, so fast. It's crazy. Oh yeah, we're rolling backwards now. Load up ahead that we're gonna have to help put theirs back together. Just like two sets of wheel things, just like wait for the bamboo thing on top and they just stick it on. That's so cool. So unsafe, I'm sure it's so unsafe. Like, we've stopped. Look, here are the wheels. How cool is it? They're the wheels, and then that's like the top bit that you sit on. So just before we came, I was reading online, and yeah, you do get, as you can expect, you get kind of accosted as you get off to buy things and stuff by the kids and whatever, and you know, which is understandable. We're just gonna have a little wander. Like, when you get here, you have like 10, 20 minutes here, where they obviously want you to buy some things, and then do you want to say hello?
Hello.
Say hello.
Hello.
And you can buy like little bands off the kids and things.
One.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe by three.
Maybe by three?
Yeah.
How much for three?
3 6,000 a real.
6,000?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
1 2,000 a real.
Oh, okay.
One.
Oh.
No, me not.
We've just bought a ton of these bracelets off these kids. Say hello.
Hello.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Bye bye. Oh yeah.
Hey,
oh yeah. Thank you. Yay! Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yay, there we go. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Thank you. You too. Bye bye. Thank you. High five. Stephen, high five. And we're off again. On our way back, and we thought maybe like you stopped in one direction, but oh, we're heading backwards. Just on our way back, and we thought that maybe like one direction was the when you got off, but somebody's got off going in the direction that we just went, so I don't really know how it works, whether
maybe
like who gets off or what the deal is, or
like,
yeah. But our guy's having to get off and help again. He's done about 5 so far. Do you like your little band?
Yeah.
I think that just cost me about $5 or something, but never mind. Got lots of bands,
yeah,
and we made a few kids happy. all done on the bamboo train. That was awesome. Did you like that?
Yeah.
That was good. Don't know where we're going next. Not sure. Gonna find our tuk-tuk driver. We're on our way to the Bat Caves, we think. And we've just stopped our tuk-tuk driver. I don't know. He's like down there. He's collecting like water lilies or like something. I don't know what he's doing. He's down in there, like behind those bushes. He's picking. There's some of these yellow, not yellow, purple flowers. Oh, you look. There he is. I don't know.
Mango, don't throw monkey, mango. Yeah.
Mm. Okay, I missed filming it, but you made a necklace with these flowers. I need to try and make one. Wow. Yeah. Ah, yeah, yeah. Yay, Stephen's got a little windmill. That's going fast, isn't it? I'm trying to make the necklace that he taught us. Just pulled over, this is where we're headed. You can't really see, but there's a Buddha and temples and stuff. So we're going up that mountain somehow in this thing. I'm not sure whether it'll take us.
Can you get them?
No, they won't show. There's the Bat Cave. You can hear them though. Was it scary? I think you can't get a tuk-tuk. Okay, so we've just like we're halfway up. What the deal is you can't get a tuk-tuk up. The hill is too steep for a tuk-tuk. So you get off and then it's like $3 for a motorbike up and down. Obviously we need one each. And it's $2 entrance as well to come up here. Don't have to pay for Stephen. The man was like, he was like, how old are they? I was like 11. And he's like, oh, what month? And I was like, 28th of this month. And he was like, ah, damn. Like, good that he didn't get an extra $2 off me. But that road up, but so far it's been so steep, hasn't it? Pretty scary. So in this little bit, we've got like a temple. And this here, I don't know whether the killing cave is through here. We're gonna go and have a little walk, explore. He told me to walk through here and come back. So I'm gonna walk through here and come back. Is it horrible? Oh no, it's not. You're right. At this place, we ask you to give some donation. Whoa, it's all like killing stuff, yeah? Look at that. Not so nice. Oh, look, it is the killing cave. The killing cave. Remember when we went to the killing fields the other day near Phnom Penh? The killing cave is the same kind of thing. It was a Khmer Rouge thing, Pol Pot thing, where they brought people up here.
There's the cave.
Under the pretense, what I understand, under pretense of like a party or something up here, from what I read, I don't know how true that is. And then they were like pushed into this cave and killed.
There's the cave.
Let's go and see. Through the trees, I don't know how well you can see that, but through the trees there's some pretty nice views out into the Cambodian countryside, isn't there?
Did you see the monkey?
No?
The real monkey? Yeah, the real monkey.
Oh, no, I didn't see.
Did you see that woman on the side of the road? Like,
no.
Sitting down.
No?
Because
you have a monkey. Look at that, that's pretty nice, isn't it? Oh, is this it? Oh. No, this isn't nice. Whoa. Yeah. Oh, there's a Buddha. A lying down Buddha.
See that bit there?
Yeah.
Why should we get off that bit in order?
I think this might be, possibly. Maybe we'll push down. That's horrific. And it just goes pitch black down there. Can't see anything. Just a terrific, isn't it? Because tuk-tuks aren't allowed up here. I don't know, I didn't know that was an option. Whoa. That's horrible. Oh, there's steps going down there. See them? Can you see where it leads to?
No.
I'm not going down. If we continue round and up, there is this. Oh, that's the Buddha that we could see from down below before, yeah, I think so. Right, we're done up here, we're going to head back, find our motorbike drivers and head back up. Hopefully the drive up is not any more steeper than it was. Does it? Oh, don't look. Really? Crap. Look at this view. Pretty amazing. Oh, look, there's some monkeys. Oh no, that one's got plastic. Look, I hate that. He was getting like the stuff that was in the plastic bag, picking it out.
Yeah.
Don't eat the plastic, mate. Careful. We're back down. That was a bit of a hairy ride down, wasn't it? It was quite scary at times. I was like gripping on for dear life. It was so steep. But we're just chilling at the bottom. Got a beer. It's about an hour or so, I think, 5:30 when the bats come out. So we're just kind of, oh, look at that Buddha's head. We're just waiting. I'll show you that Buddha's head in a second. We're just waiting for the bats, having a beer.
I can go up there.
There's the Buddha's head. Oh, you can't you? Yeah. Up these ladders. Yeah, I didn't know that. Whoa, no chance of my going up there.
Okay.
Whoa. Whoa, look at them all. You can't really see them that well, but oh my goodness, look at them flying out. And look. Whoa. That is crazy. Isn't that mad? The line of them. Literally, like, it got started to get dark and they've all just like started to fly out, haven't they? That is amazing. Out to get their food. They just keep coming, it's mad. They've probably been flying out of here for, what do you reckon, like 5 minutes now? 5 minutes, solid. So many, it's crazy.
I think 10 minutes, possibly even 10.
We've just been told that this goes on for an hour every day, them flying out. That is mad. That is so many, that is crazy. Still going, look, quite above us. You see, you might be able to see. It's flying over our head. We are back from our day out. We had a pretty awesome time, didn't we?
Yeah.
It was good. It's our one and only day in Bat Mong, which is a shame, but never mind. We are moving on to Siem Reap tomorrow. I've just booked a boat. We are going to go by boat. You can go by bus, obviously. I think it's cheaper to go by bus, but Evie, we just stayed with at the island, recommended that we do the boat, and I've looked online and loads of people said it's quite good to do the boat, so we've just booked that. We're just wandering out, we haven't eaten all day. We actually haven't, have we? We've shared a packet of crisps before. I'm not actually feeling that hungry, to be honest, but because we're doing this boat thing tomorrow, I'm not sure how much we're going to be able to get to eat tomorrow or whatever. We're getting picked up at 6:30. Yikes, after last night. Oh, I could have done with like a lion. Or I wouldn't even probably lie in, but just knowing that you'd have to get up. Anyway, I'm ranting. We're just nipping out quickly to try and get some food. And then I'm going to head back. I'm going to maybe sort out the bags and stuff. And then we're going to have an early night. So I'm just going to end the vlog here, I think. So thanks for watching. I hope you've had a wonderful day, whatever you've done. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Good night.